Welcome to ePathshala PG courses on computer science. The course is about web technology, and we are going to see the module JavaScript and event handling. The objectives of this module is to understand about the JavaScript event handling mechanisms, and we will also see how to work with HTML forms using event handling and JavaScript, and we will also learn how to work with JavaScript cookies. Now we'll see. Let us see about what is an event handler with Java in JavaScript. So using JavaScript, you can have an interaction with the HTML, and this JavaScript can interact when any event that occurs. Normally, an event occurs when a user does some operation or manipulation on a web page. So even when the page loads, it is also called as an event. So this JavaScript provides an interaction with the HTML HTML document, and when the user does some operation, an event occurs, and the action for that event would be performed by the JavaScript code which you put within the HTML document. So this JavaScript allows us to execute action of code when some event that occurs in a web page. And we can see that all the event handlers in JavaScript starts with the keyword on, and the rest of the characters would be the type of the event that it deals with so now we can see that how it actually works. So supposing the action that is going to happen is the user moves over an object. So initially, the source of an image is going to be, there is an image element, assuming that there is an image element, the source of the image element is going to be button of dot gif, this is an image. Now the user moves his mouse over the object, that is the event that happens, and we write a JavaScript code called toggle, which is going to perform the action. Now in order to access this image object to perform the action, we use the DOM. And this DOM retrieves the image object by document.image.button1, and the reaction is going to change the source from button off to button on. So this is how an event handling mechanism works. So using DOM, we identify the object in the document, and when an event occurs, when user does some operation on the document, the JavaScript code is going to execute, which performs the action. And we can see some of the event handlers to understand the rest of the examples given in this module. So we can see that there is an event handler called onAbort. This normally applies to an image element, and this event handler would be triggered when loading the when it is loaded, it gets cancelled. And there is an event handler called onBlur. This applies to many of the HTML elements like button, checkbox, password, radio, all these things. So the object in question loses focus. When the object loses focus, this event would occur. onBlur event would occur. So loses its focus means that you remove your key, or when you click outside that element, then it removes it. Loses its focus, and this event would happen. onBlur event would happen. onChange is an event handler that applies to text area, file upload or select, and the it's triggered when the data in the form element is changed by the user. And onClick applies to button, document, checkbox or any of the other form elements. This we have seen many examples. This event would be triggered when the object is clicked on. And double click, when you make a double click, this event would happen on double click. And on drag drop, this event would be triggered when an icon is dragged and dropped on a onto the browser. And on error is when any error script, JavaScript error occurs, this event would be triggered. And on focus event would be triggered when the object gains the focus. So when you click on it, or when you press your press the key, or press the move the mouse over it, it gains the focus. And key down is an event handler This would be triggered when the user presses a key. Key presses when the user presses and holds the key. Key up is when the user releases the key. On load is an event handler. It would be triggered when the whole page has finished loading. And mouse down is when the user presses the mouse button. And mouse move is when the user moves the mouse over the object, this event would happen. And mouse out is when the user moves the mouse away from the object. And mouse over is the when the user moves the mouse over the on the object, over the object. And mouse up is an event that would be triggered when the user releases a mouse button. On move is an event handler that would be triggered when the user moves the browser window or frame. And on reset when the user clicks the reset button. On resize when the user resizes the window, browser window, we have seen that the resize method, when those methods are invoked, this event would be triggered. On select is when the user selects a text in a text field or in a text area. On submit, event handler would be triggered when the user submits a form to the server. And on unload, when the user leaves the page. So, these are the common or typical event handlers one would be using when working with HTML DOM and event handling. And on click is a typical event. This would normally occur when the user clicks the left button of his mouse. So, you can see here we have a function called say hello, which would give an alert, display an alert as hello world. Now, this function would be called or this would be in action when you click on the button. So, we have an input type as button. We use the event type as event handler as on click. So, when you click on the event, when you make a click on the button, it calls the function called say hello and it calls the function say hello, and within that function you have given a alert function which will display the string called hello world. Now, this is another example which tries to change the color of the document. So, we have a function called color which takes the form object and the color, the name of the color. We tries to change the background color of the document on receiving this color. So, here you can see that we have four kinds of buttons, and when you click on any of the button, this method would be invoked, the color method or function would be invoked. It gets the form and the color, the name of the color. And the document color would be changed by the whatever value that by which you set the background of the background color of the document. So, here you can see that there are four buttons. So, when you click the red color button, then the document the background of the document would be changed as red color, and it says that it is red. So, it gives an alert message saying that the color has been changed to red. Now, how does this on submit event type works? It's an event that occurs when you try to submit a form. This normally we make use of this event type we make use of when you submit a form to the server. So, before a form is submitted, the form validation is what would be happen within this JavaScript function. So, we can say that function validate, within which we can have all our validation with respect to the form elements. So, here on submit this event would come along with the form element. So, when you submit the form, this event would be triggered and the respective action would be taking place. So, this is how this on submit event would execute. And we have an event call on mouse over and on mouse out. On mouse over event is triggered when you move your mouse over any element, any object. And on mouse event would be triggered when you move your mouse out from that element. So, here you can see that there is a function called over which tries to display or write a message as mouse over, and function out would write a message like mouse out. Now, you want to call these function over and out. So, you invoke the method when the particular event occurs. So, the event name is given as on mouse over. The handler is over. So, on when you move your mouse over that div, because within this div, the div is the element on which you want to perform this event. So, this is inside the division. This text is what? Within this div block. H2 is the element or text that is within this div block. So, when you move your mouse over, this is inside the division, it calls the function over and it displays the string as mouse over. When you move your mouse out of the div, then it displays a message as mouse out, because it calls the function out. This is another example how you work with on mouse over and on mouse out. Here you have an anchor tag, and you can see on mouse over works with the anchor tag. You tries to change the document images, the source of the image. So, initially there is an image tag whose source is given as grapes.jpg. This is an image that is displayed on the web document. Now, you associate an event with the anchor tag. You say that when you move your mouse over the anchor, this image would be changed as flower.jpg, and when you move your mouse out of that link, then that gets changed to grapes.jpg. So, the output would be displayed like this. So, initially it is grapes.jpg, when you move your mouse over it, it gets changed to flower.jpg, when you move your mouse out of it, it again gets changed to grapes.jpg. And now, let us see about how JavaScript form validation would happen with HTML by accessing the HTML DOM elements. So, this form validation can also be done using JavaScript. This is where we actually need this JavaScript. So, here this is a simple example. We want to validate the form. We want to make sure that we enter some value in a text field. So, we have a field called fname. So, we have a document and we have a form called myform. The name of the form is given as myform, and then we have a text field. The name of the text field is given as fname. So, we want to assure that the user enters some text value in the text field. So, we write a statement like document.forms, that is the my form, and the dot fname, that is the name of the text field, dot value. We retrieve its value and we check if it is null or if it is blank. If it is null or blank, we give an alert saying that the name must be filled out. So, this function validate form would be called on submit of this form. So, on submit is the event that gets associated with the form element. So, on submit of the form, we call the function, JavaScript function called validate form, which says that you have to enter the value in the name field. And then this is another example where we will work with the select method. So, here too, you have a form, and then there is a text area. We have created a text area. Initially, the text that appears in the text area is the roots of education are bitter, but the fruit is sweeter. And we have a button called on click. So, when you make a click of the button, it calls the function called new value. So, come and see what is written in the new value. We can see here document.forms.myform. We retrieve the form object, we locate the form object, and we take the value of the text field, and we now change the value of it as the mere act of aiming at something makes you big, and we make it as x of 0, that is the first element in the form. X of 0 denotes the first element in the form, that is the first the text area which you have created in the form. So, the value has been changed, and you make it, use the method called select, which will display the text as selected text. Now, we can see how this the output appears. So, new value is a button, on click it calls the function which changes the text value displayed in the text area and make it as a selected text. And this is another example how we work with checkboxes and radio buttons within forms. So, here we can see that there is a function called check. We pass the form object here, and now we have in this form, we have a checkbox and there are two radio buttons. There are three text fields. You can see there are three text fields. There are two radio buttons, one checkbox and one button. On click of the button, it validates these fields. So, we have not written any validation for the input field. Now, we concentrate on writing some validation on the radio button and the checkbox. So, with the checkbox, it uses the property called checked. So it now sets the set the property checked as true. So now we can say that checkbox would be selected. You have a tick symbol in the checkbox and give an alert message, the checkbox just got checked. And then again we change the checked property as false, it goes off. And then we change the radio button. There are two radio buttons, it forms as an array. Radio of 0 whose checked property would be true, and radio of 1 whose checked property would be false. And you get an alert message, the radio button just got checked. So you can see your output here. There are two radio buttons, there is one checkbox. So it has been checked and then it has been made false, which goes off. Then again the radio button made us true and this one made us false. This is where you check it and then the message as the checkbox got checked is displayed. Again when this is okay, then it makes these two changes and say that the radio buttons get checked. This is another example where you have used the event call on focus. So there is a text field call first name. When you make the event is on focus, you call the method called blur. This is a defined method. So when you make your focus on the text field, it makes it to lose the focus. Blur is for losing the focus. So it will not allow the user to enter any text in the text field called first name. So here you can see that all other fields you can enter value, whereas the first name, because on focus is you bring your focus into the text field. When you bring your focus into the text field, you call the method called blur method, which removes the focus, which makes the element loses its focus. So here you will not able to enter any value into the text field called first name. And now here is an example where you make use of the event call on reset. So this event would be triggered when you click the reset button. So when you click the reset button, whatever value that you have entered in the form will go off, will get resetted, will get cleared. So on reset, you call a function called function and you pass the form object. So here you can see that there is a function called function which receives this form object through F1, the parameter called F1. You give an alert message saying that the form elements have been cleared. So here this example you can see there is a text field and then you have another text field. There are two radio buttons, there is a checkbox and there is a reset button. Now the output would be like this. You try to enter the values on the within all these text fields. You click on the radio button, you check the checkbox, and when you click, there is a button called reset button. When you click the reset button, what happens? All the things would be cleared, and then the form it displays a message on click of the reset button. You can see here on reset it calls the function as FUNC, function name is function. This gives the alert messages the form elements have been cleared. And this is another example by which you can make a calculation with there are two text fields. Now one would be the result field and another would be an entry field. So there are two text fields. You can see here you create a text field with the name entry, you give a value as blank, and there is another field with the name results and you have a button the value is given as calculate. And now here you can see that there are events associated with not with the entry field, but there is an event associated with the button and with the result field. So here what is the event you are doing with the result field? You can see here you don't want the user to enter some value in the result field. The entry field you allow the user to enter some value. When he enters some value and click the button, there is a button. So you can see here there is an entry field and there is a result field. Entry field it allows the user to enter a value, and when he clicks the button calculate, you can see on click you call the function called calculate, and then in the in the result field is not allowing the user to enter any value. So you can see here we use the event called on focus. When the user is trying to bring his mouse or his key pointer into the text field, the result text field, it calls a method called blur. It's a defined method, this dot blur. So what happens, the user would not be allowed to enter any value in the result field. So this calculation would be done based on the value that is entered in the entry field. So here it makes an eval, it's evaluate the expression by the value that is entered in the entry field. So form dot entry dot value into 10 would be what displayed in the result field. So you know that how you access the value field form, the form which you have passed here dot, this is the name of the text field results whose value is now set with multiplying the value of the entry field's value. So form dot the element name, the text field name is entry dot value whose value is now multiplied by 10, and that would be shown in the result field. And now this is another example to work with JavaScript forms. Here you can see that there are two text fields, one is an entry field and another one is the result field. So you can see that there is a field called entry, there is a checkbox whose name is square, and there is another text field called result. Now you associate three kinds of three events with these three fields. So initially our form would look like this: there is a text field, there is another field, this is their values, the name of the field is value, this the name of this field is result, and this is the checkbox its name is given as square. Now you can see here with the entry text field, you have given the event as on change. You call the function calculate by passing the form and passing the name of the field. And when you make a click on the checkbox, so you associate an event called on click. When you click on the checkbox, you call again the calculate method, and again the third field is the result field. On change means you are changing the value that is stored in the field. So on change event that is given in the result text field, you call the calculate function. So this calculate function is actually checking whether the calling field is a result field or the calling field is an entry field, else part is the entry field. So if it is the result field, then it checks whether the checkbox is checked. So form dot square is the name of the checkbox. The property of the checkbox is checked, it checks whether checkbox is checked. If so, it performs a calculation of square root of the value that is entered in the result field. Else, if the checkbox is not checked, then it does the value taken from the result field and divide it by 2. So this will happen, this square root or division would happen if you enter a value in the result field. So if the calling field is result, so you call the event on change from the result field. The else part will work for the entry field. So here too you are checking whether the square box is checked or not checked. If the square box is checked, then the result field will get a value by getting the square of the entry field's value. So entry value into entry dot value, which is whatever value that you have entered in the entry field will be multiplied with it, and that would be shown in the result field. If the square box is not checked, else part, so the result would be now entry, the what value have entered in the entry field multiplied by 2. So you perform a square or multiplication by 2 if the calling field is the entry field, and you perform a square root or division if the calling field is a resultant field. And within this you will check whether this checkbox is checked or not checked. So it performs, so you can enter some value in the value field, and when you check when you click on the square box, it gets a value, one value, one perform one calculation, that is 6 into 36, that 6 into 6 would be 36, you will get it. When you uncheck the square box, if it is not checked, and if you change the value here, you will get 6 into 2 12, you will get displayed. And when the value in the result field gets changed, you will again get a square root here if the checkbox is checked, and you will get a division by 2 if the square box is not checked. So, this is how you can associate event with forms and perform calculation. Now, we can also work with JavaScript cookies. Cookies are used to store information on the user's computer, where even when he switches off his or her computer, this cookie would get stored in the user's computer. So, it is a text file, the cookie is a text file. This cookie would be helpful for the web server to remember the user. So, once the cookie gets stored in the client side as a text field, text value, and again when the user loads or visits the same page or he interacts with the server, this cookie, the cookie value would be sent along with the request to the server, and with which the server would now remember the user. So, it is a data that is sent from the making it that the web server remembers now the web browser. But when the user visits a site on a server, cookie would be remembered by the cookie stored in the client, and it is actually sent to the server, and with which the server now identifies the user. So, this cookie it can be associated with one or more documents, or more than one cookie you can put it for a single document. When you take a cookie, this cookie would have a value as a pair, that is name and a value would be associated. It is a pair of value that is stored as a cookie value, and cookies can also have expiration date associated with them. Now, its cookie has got five variable length fields. Each cookie you can store all these things. The expiration date of the cookie you can give it. You can give the domain name of your site using the domain field. You can say the path to the directory or the web page that set the cookie by using the field called path. And secure, if this field is set only if the server is secure, it would be able to access the cookie. And you will give the cookie stored as a name value pair in order to get retrieved. So, if you want to create a cookie in JavaScript, you use document.cookie equal to, it is a string, and you can have key value pairs, put a semicolon, and you can have number of key value pairs, and you can also have the expiration date for the cookie. So, this is the code to store the cookies. You can see here you are writing, you have a method called write cookie, and you want to store the cookie in the client side. So, whatever value that is returned in the customer field, customer is a text field, value is the value of the text field, you retrieve the text field in order to escape from the blank characters and other special characters, you can make use of the function called escape. Now, use the method document.cookie and save the cookie value, you have the cookie value now, okay. And then you can display the cookie value which has been set for this. And in order to read the cookies, when it read the cookies, it is actually an array. So, use the same thing document.cookie to retrieve the cookies, and this cookie is an array. You have to use the split function to separate the key value pairs and put a for loop and display the name and the value field, the name what you have stored for the cookie and the value. So, you say that cookie array of I, that is the 0th cookie, the first the text that is stored in the cookie dot split by equal to, you take the name and then equal the 1 says that you are taking the value and you are trying to display. So, this module we have seen that how we handle events in JavaScript, and we have seen that how we are working with form validation, HTML form validation using HTML DOM and event handling, and we have also seen that how to work with JavaScript cookies. Thank you.